So, and thanks to the organizers to give me the opportunity to show our results here in this online conference format. So I'm actually streaming from Tobias' office, and today I will talk about tools for the performance optimization of single photon based quantum key distribution. So first of all, I will talk a little bit about single photon quantum key distribution in general before I will present our QKD testbed. And with this testbed, we investigated different possibilities to improve the performance of single photon-based quantum key distribution systems, such as temporal filtering and real-time security monitoring. In the end, after the summary, I will give a brief outlook. So first of all, if you want to measure the performance of quantum key distribution systems, we should talk about secret key rates. The secret key rates for practical single photon sources differ a little bit from these of the decoy state protocol secret key rate equations. So where the sifted key rate and the quantum bit error ratio is quite similar, we have another fraction which deals with a multi-photon emission probability, which could be used in a photon number splitting attack. And to estimate this number in practical single photon based QKD systems, we use this equation from Wax et al., which gives us an upper bound on the multiphoton emission probability if we have knowledge about our G2 of zero value and the mean photon number into the quantum channel. And at this point, I would also highlight that we can mainly distinguish two different performance optimization goals. On the one hand side, for low losses, one wants to increase the overall achievable secret key rate on the one hand side, but on the other hand side, we want, of course, have systems in certain situations, such as satellite QKD, where we have a really high loss budget. So as our QKD testbed, we have on the sender side, on LSS side, a quantum dot single photon source embedded into a microlens structure, we have a deterministically integrated quantum dot device. So instead of the entanglement properties of such a quantum dot systems, we are using only the single photon properties. And as you can see here, we have a quite reasonable single photon purity at an emission range wavelength of 980 nanometers. We are exciting the quantum dot with Fischer excitation with an 80 megahertz OPPO laser. Then for our tests, we used fixed polarizations as an input for our polarization analyzer or receiver module BOP, where we have a passive basis choice realized with the 50-50 beam splitter and polarizing beam splitters for the polarization state discrimination in the end. The outputs of our BOP module are connected via 50 micron multimode fibers to silicon avalanche photon diodes. So at first, we did the evaluation of our polarization analyzer. How good does it behave? So therefore, we put into a fixed polarization into our system and looked at the response of the different detection channels. And as we can see here, we have a lot of lifetime or time-resolved photoluminescence measurements. And if we put in an H-polarized state into our systems, we can, of course, obtain the HV basis, mainly H-polarized detection events. However, in the opposite basis, we have a projection, an equal projection to both states, diagonal and anti-diagonal, as can be reproduced in our measurements. We did this for all four possible input polarization states. However, if we renormalize to achieve the arrival time distribution, one can see that there are still some residual events in the wrong detection channel, which will be the quantum bit error ratio contribution of our receiver module in full QKD implementations. So now, if we have a closer look, we can distinguish different contributions to the quantum bit error ratio in our system. So we have regions where we have uncorrelated detection events which can be attributed to our detector noise. So we had around 100 dark cones per second. On the other hand side, we have some correlated events which can be attributed to optical imperfections in our setup. Now, to reduce the error contribution, or to say it other way around, to improve our quantum bit error ratio, we can discard events which lie outside a certain acceptance time window, as depicted here. As we can see here, if we reduce the acceptance time window, the quantum bit error ratio can be enhanced due to the better signal to noise ratio. However, there is a certain limitation. In our case, it is due to our optical imperfections in the setup. However, one has to have, there's a trade-off between the sifted key fractions, since we are also discarding some useful key material. So far, we did this temporal filtering only around our maximum of the photon arrival time distribution. However, since we have a highly asymmetrical shape of our photon arrival time distribution, it is more beneficial to do the 2D temporal filtering. 2D in this sense that we change the center position of our timing window, and for each center position, we change the acceptance time window width as well. If we are in a region where we have only noise, then no secret key rate can be achieved. But if we filter too narrow, the secret key rate might also be not optimal, since we are discarding too much of a valuable sifted key rate. So there is also always the trade-off to find the optimal value. So depicted here is the secret key rate back-to-back calculated from the quantum bit error ratio, the sifted key rate, and our G2 of zero value. Since we had only one system at our hand at this time, we did some simulations employing different lifetime distributions. And as we can see here, basically, if we have a very short pulses regarding the repetition rate of your QKD system, or if you're in a regime with very high noise, which comes if you have very high losses, then this temporal filtering is really crucial to achieve the optimal achievable secret key rate. So we can achieve in the simulations up to 180% performance increase. So to wrap everything up with this temporal filtering, we can show that at least for our system, we could achieve a range extension of about 28 decibel to about 38 decibel. However, if we are operating in a lower loss regime, it might be more beneficial not to filter as strong, since there the unfiltered achievable secret key rate is much higher. So far, we used our fixed or pre-estimated single photon purity, and the unfiltered autocorrelation function. However, one can see here that our receiver module resembles an HBT setup. So in principle, it is possible to use the detection events which we use for the quantum key distribution also to calculate our G2 of zero function and therefore estimate our multi-photon emission probability in our setup. So if we apply this temporal filtering and do the autocorrelation out of these temporal filter timestamps, we can clearly see that there's, of course, since we have a better signal to noise ratio, one can better estimate the real single photon purity of its source. I would like to mention that this is different from cutting the histogram after you did the autocorrelation. So we autocorrelate the filter timestamps instead of using just a fraction of the calculated histogram. So if we apply not only the temporal filtering for taking into account the sifted key rate and the quantum bit error ratio, but use also the enhanced G2 of zero value, one can see clearly here that there is an even better range extension achievable. What one has to take in mind if one wants to use this filtered autocorrelation function, one has also to filter the photons at the sender side. Otherwise, one could overestimate or the single photon purity of its of your own source, opening potential channels for an attack. So another important factor in real implementations is of course the constant monitoring of the different security parameters. Therefore, we did one test measurement with a fixed input polarization of about 90 minutes. And as we can see here from the counterfeiter ratio, we calculated from all the time sinks, which cannot be realized in a complete or full implementation. And we had a really stable setup, which is also reflected in the G2 of zero value. We did accumulation times of 60 or 360 seconds to evaluate our G2 of zero value over time. In this context, we also asked ourselves what is a reasonable integration or accumulation time to estimate the G2 of zero value. And as you can see from this plot, even after 60 seconds, there's also already a reasonable error margin. But if you go even higher to 360 seconds, of course, the error becomes even lower. And block sizes with 1 million to 10 million bits are also quite reasonable for classical key reconciliation schemes. So to sum everything up, I first introduced you to our QKD testnet, where we tested our methods to boost the performance of single photon-based quantum QKD systems. We did this via temporal filtering. We could show that for our system, in a full implementation, range extensions up to 10 dB would be achievable. And in the last part, I also showed you how we can use our methods for real-time security monitoring. As a brief outlook, our next step would be to use fiber-coupled to develop fiber-coupled single photon sources for the telecom O-band with these already mentioned bullseye structures, which promise fiber coupling efficiency up to 80%. And this is more on the sender side. On the receiver side, we would of course, well, in the full implementation side, we would of course now go to polarization modulation via electro-optical modulators. We want to fully implement those plug-and-play single photon sources. And for higher frequencies, we will also go to electrically triggered single photon sources. And currently, there are ongoing O-band quantum key distribution experiments where we want to use such a fiber-coupled source in a Stirling cryostat, such as a plug-and-play quantum dot single photon source as our sender. And we also made an improved version of our receiver module with better polarization extinction ratios in the telecom O-band. And at the end, I would like to thank my work group and the funding agencies and the collaborators and you for your attention.